Tomorrow will be the start of the last ceasefire weekend of the year. This is where we call for no murders in the city of Baltimore, our city on pace to surpass 300 homicides for the seventh year in a row.
WMER 2 News' Ray Strickland spoke to the co-founder of Baltimore Ceasefire 365 about why she remains so committed to helping change Baltimore for the better despite all the continued violence.
Co-founder of Baltimore and Ceasefire 365, Erica Bridgeford, says she actually feels discouraged going into this ceasefire weekend. It, in large part, has to do with the gun violence that continues to take a toll on the city. But she says she remains unfazed, knowing that her work is needed now more than ever.
I am always heartbroken by murder.
This is Erica Bridgeford blessing the space where someone was shot and killed in Baltimore.
I don't want to be numb to people being killed.
It's one of the ways she helps communities heal from the trauma brought on by gun violence in the city.
It's a part of my purpose.
Have your heart for peace in your city!
Her passion is changing Baltimore for the better by promoting peace and love. Starting Friday, she's calling for people to once again put the guns down and stop the killings.
I hope that I don't have to meet a family because they lost somebody this weekend. But if I do, I'm going to be very grateful for that opportunity that I could be called to be any kind of comfort to somebody in that situation.
This year's last ceasefire weekend comes after a violent Halloween weekend where at least 5 people were killed. It capped a deadly October month of more than 25 murders.
I feel the temptation of hopelessness weighing on me right now, just from how hard the work is and how overwhelming all of it is.
The city is on pace for more than 300 homicides for the seventh year in a row.
I know that if we stop, it's going to get 10 times worse.
Which is why Bridgeford says despite the continued violence, she remains committed to helping change the city for the better.
When you're doing the work every day, you see the impact that you're having because people in Baltimore let you know how much they appreciate your good work when it's impacting their life. Yes, we get discouraged in Baltimore sometimes, but we don't give up.
And there's a number of events taking place during this ceasefire weekend. For more information, you can go to our website at WMAR2News.com. Reporting in Baltimore, Ray Strickland, WMAR2 News.